Emily, I know that the last time we saw you, the fight didn't go exactly as you hoped, but were there some great things, maybe from the whole experience leading up to it, and from that fight that you were able to take to move forward with?
I think I had a really good camp for that fight. I knew going into that fight with Jillian that her ground was really good, and that the only way I was going to lose to her was by something sneaky like that. So I didn't really change a whole lot for this camp, just going in and prepared like I was last time, and hope definitely getting a different outcome.
Yeah. Well, and I think maybe, do you think last time you guys were like bunkmates? There was an established relationship.
Yeah.
So does it already feel different going into a fight with somebody you don't have an established relationship with that maybe would affect the fight differently? Or
I don't think my relationship with Jillian like affected the fight very much, but I do, I am really happy that I'm not fighting somebody that I lived with, that I shared a bunk with. Me and Jillian did spend a lot of time in the house together. We always were hanging out like after hours and stuff. So I'm just happy to fight somebody that is not my friend.
A lot made on the show about you know, what your living situation was going to be after the show and you know, for the foreseeable future. Is that all sorted out now?
Yeah, it's all sorted out. When I came back, I stayed in one of Misha's condos for a little bit and then got my own apartment shortly after that, and I'm still living in that apartment.
One of Misha's condos, is she?
Her only condo.
Well, now with all these condos.
Her only condo, I think she only has one right now.
So is all well now?
Everything's fine. Yeah, it just made sense for me to put all my stuff into storage, just because that living situation that I was in before, like, kind of was getting a little bit rocky, and like paying all that rent while I wasn't going to be there and stuff. So it just kind of made sense. It just felt like the universe was kind of pushing me out of there.
Was it always going to be Las Vegas though?
Always going to be Las Vegas. Yeah, as long as I'm fighting, I'm going to be here in Vegas.
Is there any particular reason for that?
My relationship with everybody at Extreme Couture, my coaches, they all know me really well. We work well together, my training partners, and I love living in Vegas. It's a great town to live in. If you're out to like thrive and get something, this town can be very good to you, and it's been good to me so far.
Do you come to the PI pretty often?
Not a lot. I do keep most of my training still over at Extreme. I do come in and use the treadmills, and I'll come eat a little bit, but for the most part, I haven't been here too much.
Are you still serving?
I am, a little bit. It's kind of weird. I don't actually have any shifts, but if the girls need help, then I'll pick up and stuff. I try and not pick up any shifts close to the fight, but outside, and football's coming up, and so I'll definitely probably work football. We're a Patriots bar, and all the Patriots fans love me, so I'll definitely be working the Patriot games.
I was going to say, for that particular job, it's probably the perfect for fighting on the side. Your schedule works around your training schedule?
Yeah, they definitely work with my schedule there. I work for great people. My manager's great, so it's just a really good job. I got really lucky. Actually, one of my head coaches, Eric Nixick, he's been working there since he was 18, and so he still bartends a couple nights a week. So just like a really close-knit like group of people there. There's only like three people on a shift, so everyone's pretty close.
You ever been recognized by a patron coming and saying, hey, you look like that fighter?
Nobody's recognized me, but most people know that I am a fighter, and like people will like always ask me if I have anything coming up, or if they haven't seen me for a while, they'll ask the girls like where I've been, if I have fights coming up and stuff. So everyone there is super supportive.
All right, well, let's talk about your opponent a little bit. Break her down for us. Where is she dangerous?
I think Jamie, she might be a little bit dangerous everywhere. She's well-rounded. She likes to go to the ground. She has good stand-up. So I think it's a good matchup. She seems like a well-rounded MMA fighter as myself. So I think it's just going to be a good fight. I've watched her fight since she fought Invicta. I watched her in the Tough House. So I've always known who Jamie was, and I've always thought it would be an interesting matchup. And so it was kind of funny when I got offered that. And I'm excited to fight her, really excited. I think it's a good matchup for myself, and I'm sure she thinks the same. So I think it's just going to be a good fight.
It's kind of like a cross-town rivalry, right?
Yeah, a little bit, but now Jamie's over at Team Alpha Male. So before, Extreme Couture and Syndicate don't really like each other, but I still don't think it would have really been any like bad blood between us.
Is there some conflict between those two sides?
Yeah, it seems like our gyms don't like each other very much, but it seems like everyone's like kind of cool. Like it's kind of more like a joking around beef for a little bit, maybe.
Jim versus Jim, or just the females at each gym?
No, Jim versus Jim. Me and Roxy, we talk all the time, not all the time, but if I see her, we talk and everything. So none of the girls there have any beef with any of the girls at our gym, so I think everyone's cool.
What was the addition of Claudia Gadelia like a few months ago?
That was amazing. I actually met Claudia a couple years ago when I went and trained at Albuquerque, and so me and her had stayed kind of in contact throughout that, and then she had been messaging me about coming to Vegas, and so I had known she was coming here, and I love training with her. It's been great training for myself, and she's just a really good friend, a good person, and I'm just happy she's here.
You're sharing the card with like some of the current fighters of Tough and having been through it yourself. What's something that maybe they're going through right now, even if they don't realize they're going through it?
I don't know. I think Tough's like different for everyone. Some people like really thrive in the Ultimate Fighter house, and then some people don't do so well in it. You're really isolated. They take you away from your comfort zone, and so it's a hard thing to do. It was hard for me. Other people, it didn't seem to bother them so much. So I think it's just different for everyone. So it's kind of hard to say.
And what was it like going like from fighting in the Tough gym to fighting in a full out arena?
What was that?
Like from fighting in the Tough gym to fighting in a big arena with all the lights on. How was that?
It was weird fighting in the Tough gym. I had fought Pack the Mac is this weekend. It's a free event that Tough Enough throws on, and I fought in front of 16,000 people before. So, and I'd been main event on casino cards. So it really wasn't that different for me. It was weird fighting in a small gym where there's no walkout music. It's just quiet. You only hear your friends and teammates, you know, cheering. So it's a weird environment to fight in there, but not in a big arena, I don't think.
A few weeks ago, you had your birthday,
mm-hmm.
and your team members kind of came out. And what was it? What was that, like entertainment or a talent show? I saw it on social media.
It was a dance-off. I thought we were doing cardio, and so I was all excited to do cardio, and then Eric called me out to the middle of the mat, and everyone danced for me, and so it was like a little dance-off, and I got to pick the winner, but I didn't end up picking anyone. I was a little disappointed.
So pick a winner now. Do you remember, did anybody stand out?
I'm going to go with Pooney just because he did a little like Michael Jackson Indo, and so then I'm going to go with Pooney. But I was a little disappointed him or Don didn't do a backflip. They're both break dancers and they're like really good dancers, and so I was like, why didn't you guys do a backflip? I went over to both of them afterwards and asked.
Cool. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, guys. Got one more.